Good morning. Good morning to all of you that are here with us in the house. A good morning to all of you that are with us online. A good morning to our television congregation. Good morning and God bless you all. But the Helper will teach you everything and will cause you to remember all that I told you. This Helper is the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name. Jesus made this promise in John chapter 14, verse 26. Jesus promised us someone who would teach us. Jesus promised us someone who would bring to our remembrance all of his wonderful words. Jesus promised us not just a helper, no, but the helper. 2 weeks ago, we learned characteristic number one, the Holy Spirit is a loving helper. And 2 weeks ago, we also learned characteristic number two, the Holy Spirit is a faithful helper. Today, we continue our exploration of the five characteristics of the Holy Spirit, our helper. Characteristic number three, the Holy Spirit is a wise helper. Say that with me. The Holy Spirit is a wise helper. Not all help is help. Would you agree to that? Not all help is helpful. Would you also agree to that? And certainly not all help is informative, compassionate, and biblically wise. Can I get an amen? Amen. Job knew that. Now, I'm sure that Job's friends thought that they were wise. I'm sure that Job's friends thought that they were helpful. But when you read the book of Job, you quickly discover that Job's friends, well, they just didn't get it. They did not understand Job's situation. And the sad part is that they didn't bother to take the time to find out. They did not see his broken heart, and they did not see the depths of his pain. What they did was jump to unfounded conclusions and presented him with a poisonous prescription for his problem. And instead of Job's friends being healers, instead they were herders. Let's be honest. Don't we all too often do the same thing? Somebody shares their story of their heartache, their loss, their pain. And before they've even finished telling their story, we've already concocted a prescription for their problem. Our intentions, I believe, are good. We really do want to help. But that is not help. It is hurt that we bring. And that is why we need a wise helper. That is why we need the Holy Spirit. For you see, when we are filled with the Holy Spirit, we are wise helpers. The wise helper, hear me now, takes a person's soul, lays it out on the operating table, and carefully dissects it. The wise helper prayerfully asks the Holy Spirit to reveal to them the root of the problem. The wise helper sees the pain, sees the problem, and then wisely uses the scalpel of the Spirit when spiritual and emotional surgery is required. Hear me, please. When the Holy Spirit moves, do not hesitate to follow Him. Let me say that again. When the Holy Spirit moves in your life, do not hesitate to follow Him. Why? It is because the Holy Spirit will never, ever, ever lead you astray. Give Him some praise. When you are reading the Bible and the Holy Spirit speaks to you, listen. When you are engaged in prayer and the Holy Spirit speaks to you, listen. When you are in a small group Bible study and the Holy Spirit speaks to you, listen. When you are in worship and the Holy Spirit speaks to you, listen, and don't just listen, hear me now, obey. Don't just listen, obey. Follow His leading. Do not resist Him, for Jesus said, He, the Holy Spirit, will teach you all things. Now, when it says all things, it means all things without exception. You never have to worry about being in a place where it's saying, well, it doesn't apply to me. He doesn't get what I'm going through. Yes, he does. Yes, he does. Do not resist him. The Holy Spirit, Jesus said that the Holy Spirit will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all that I said to you. Many years ago, there was a church in Philadelphia, and they had an outreach to the community in the suburbs, and many families would bring their children to Sunday school. And one day there was a parent that brought their child, and instead of sticking around, they just left, as is often the case. But the problem was is that they got there about 20 minutes late into the Sunday school hour. And so there's this little child that walks up to the door of his Sunday school class, but the door is closed. And so the Sunday school director was making his rounds and walking down the hallway and came up and said, Son, don't you want to go in there and learn more about the Bible? And he said, sir, I'm having enough trouble with what I already know. Often it's not new information that we need. We need to be reminded of what we've already been told. And that's what the Holy Spirit does. The Holy Spirit does. The Holy Spirit will lead you if you'll let him. The Holy Spirit will do that. The Holy Spirit does just that. The Holy Spirit is a wise helper. Characteristic number four. The Holy Spirit is an active helper. The Holy Spirit is an active helper. The Holy Spirit does not provide us with comfort by words alone. The Holy Spirit also comforts us, watch this now, by his actions. The Holy Spirit acts how? By giving wisdom. Now, what is the difference between wisdom and knowledge? Wisdom is when God gives you what you need to be able to do, to be able to handle what you already know. We can have a whole lot of facts and not know what the heck to do with them. But God will give you that wisdom. The Holy Spirit acts by giving us wisdom. The Holy Spirit acts by giving us understanding. The Holy Spirit acts by giving us God's promises. The Holy Spirit acts by giving us grace. The Holy Spirit acts by giving us Christ's comfort. The Holy Spirit is actively building your relationship with your Heavenly Father. Romans chapter 8, verse 15 says, so you have not received a spirit that makes you fearful slaves. Smack three people and tell them, stop being afraid. Now, I said smack because sometimes you got to smack people into some sense. So you have not received a spirit that makes you fearful slaves. What does that mean? It means when you're in, anybody been enslaved to anything? Your fear, oh, this is going to happen, that's going to happen. A lot of us are running around waiting for the other shoe to drop. You need to put your shoes in the closet and stop worrying about it. You're not a slave. You're not enslaved to that. You've been liberated when you came to Christ. The chains are gone. The shackles are gone. Walk in your freedom. Say that with me. Walk in your freedom. Better yet, personalize it. Say this with me. I'm going to walk in my freedom. I'm going to walk in my freedom. So you have not received a spirit that makes you fearful slaves. Instead, say instead, you received God's Spirit when he adopted you as his own children. Next slide. Instead, you have received God's Spirit when he adopted you as his own children. Now we call him Abba, Father. Now, Abba is a wonderful, wonderful word. I was listening to Max Lucado's podcast as I was taking a walk the other day. I walk a 5K every day just to stay on this side of the grass. Old man told me one time, he said, every day this side of the grass is good, but on the other side is even better. And I'm just trying to stay here a little longer. So I'm listening to Max Lucado's podcast, and one of the things when he was talking about prayer is that he said, isn't it fascinating that when we're in a setting like this in church, someone will stand up and say, oh, Heavenly Father, I thank thee for thy many blessings. Who among us would go up to our daddy when we're little and say, "Oh, Heavenly Father, I thank thee for thy many blessings"? We don't talk that way to the people we love. So we need to throw that kind of language out. Say, throw it out. And we need to know that we have not just a Heavenly Father, but we have an intimate daddy. Daddy. You know what a daddy is? A daddy's somebody you can come to. A daddy's somebody that'll pick you up when you fall down. A daddy's somebody who'll wipe your tears when you cry. A daddy is somebody who's always going to be there when everybody else is gone. A daddy is somebody that loves you. A daddy is somebody that's not going to put up with somebody else putting you down. A daddy's going to step up and defend you. That's who your daddy is. And your daddy has a name, and his name is your Heavenly Father, and he loves you. Give him some praise. And because we have the Holy Spirit living within us, we can call him relationally because of what Jesus did, making a pathway on the cross. We can call him Daddy. Say, Daddy. So next time somebody asks you, who's your daddy? Now you know what to tell them. Great passage. The Holy Spirit will actively guide you. Watch this now, if you'll let him. The Holy Spirit will actively direct you if you'll let him. The Holy Spirit will actively lead you if you'll let him. Listen to what Isaiah chapter 11 verse 2 tells us about the Holy Spirit coming upon Jesus. The Bible says, "And the Spirit of the Lord will rest on him." When we read the Bible, that's the experience that Jesus had when he was baptized by John the Baptist in the Jordan River. And the Bible says that when he came up out of the river, we have one of those examples in scriptures where we have the Trinity joining together in triumph there as Jesus comes up out of the water. There is the Son of God coming up out of the water. The Bible says that it was like a dove descended upon him. That is the Holy Spirit. And then a voice called out from the heavens and said, "This is my beloved Son in whom I'm well pleased." The Holy Spirit rested upon Jesus. Watch this. The Spirit of wisdom and understanding. The Spirit of counsel and might. The Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. Child of God, have you been given a different spirit than the one that rested on Jesus? This is not a trick question. Have you been given a different spirit than the one that rested upon Jesus? Talk to me. No. Say no. I don't want you going out of here going, "I'm not sure." Say no. 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 This is God's Holy Spirit. And if you got Jesus, you got the Holy Ghost. If you've got Jesus, you've got the Holy Ghost. You have the Spirit of wisdom. You have the Spirit of understanding residing within you. You have the Spirit of wise counsel. You have the Spirit of might residing within you. You have the Spirit of knowledge residing within you. You have the Spirit of reverential respect of God residing within you. So allow the Holy Spirit to be active in your life. Allow him to guide you, for he will lead you on the path of righteousness. Allow him to direct you, for he will warn you of danger. Allow him to address the sin in your life, for he will convict you when you have gone astray. Allow him to draw you to Jesus, for that, my friend, is the only place you want to be. The only place you want to be. The Holy Spirit is an active helper. And now that brings us to our fifth and final characteristic of the Holy Spirit. Fifth and final characteristic of the Holy Spirit. Characteristic number 5. The Holy Spirit is an ever-present helper. An ever-present helper. This is an undeniable, indisputable, indefatigable biblical truth. If you have received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, God is always with you. God is always with you. When you are in distress, say this with me, God is there. When you are depressed, what? God is there. Psalm 46 verse 1 tells us, God is our refuge and strength. You know what a refuge is? Literally, when you read that in the Hebrew, there are some alternate translations there. This is, God is our fortress. That's a place when everybody is attacking you, you can run in there and be all right. God is our refuge and our strength. Anybody feeling weak today? I know some of us are feeling physically weak. I know some of us are feeling emotionally shot. I know some of us are just have had our world completely blown apart. I know there are some of us, because of what we've gone through or what we're going through, we're finding it difficult, if not impossible, to put one foot in front of the next. I came today to tell you that if you want some strength, it's already within you. It's already within you. God is our refuge and strength and ever present help in trouble. And ever present help in trouble. God is an ever present help in trouble. God will never leave you, no matter what. God will never forsake you, no matter what. God's love is always pointed in your direction. God's love is always pointed in your direction. The Apostle Paul knew this. That is why in Romans chapter 8, verses 38 and 39, he writes, I'm absolutely convinced that nothing, say nothing, nothing living or dead, angelic or demonic, today or tomorrow, high or low, thinkable or unthinkable. I think that covers it all, don't you? Absolutely nothing, say nothing, can get between us and God's love. Why? Because of the way that Jesus our Master has embraced us. Nothing can get in the way of God's love. God did not call you out of bondage just to leave you wandering in the wilderness. Jesus did not save you just to abandon you to make it on your own. The Bible says that God sent you an ever-present helper to be with you forever. Give him some praise. So if you'll allow old Doc Painter to conduct some classes here now, let's have a review of what we've learned so far. Characteristic number one, let's say it together. The Holy Spirit is a loving helper. Characteristic number two, the Holy Spirit is a faithful helper. Characteristic number three, the Holy Spirit is a wise helper. Characteristic number four, the Holy Spirit is an active helper. Characteristic number five, the Holy Spirit is an ever-present helper. Say this with me now. Next slide, please. Praise God for the Holy Ghost. Stand to your feet, if you will, please. Lift your hands high to the heavens in an act of worship. Let's say it again. Praise God for the Holy Ghost. Say it again. Praise God for the Holy Ghost. One more time. Praise God for the Holy Ghost. Now put your hands together and give him some praise.
Come on, that message, so, so powerful. It's an amazing message with practical tools. Right now in the chat, give somebody a high five. Don't click off. I know you might think that service is over, but it's not. We still have some amazing information to share with you. We have one question for you today. You just heard an amazing sermon, so what are you going to do about it? The first step is to give your life to Christ. If you've never given your life to Christ, why not today? You don't get it by watching us. You don't get it by rules or rituals. You get it by having a personal, real relationship with Christ. If you want that today, pray this with me right now. Jesus, come into my heart. I receive you as my Lord and Savior. God, I give you my life. I give you total control of my life. I believe you are who you say you are, and I believe everything the Bible said you did. And I ask you to come into my life. I know that I'm a sinner, and I ask for forgiveness today. I want to trust to follow you as my Lord and Savior. In Jesus Christ's name we pray, amen. If you prayed that with me right now, God just came into your heart to live inside of you. I want you to go right now to cresthill.org/connect. This is means for a party. This is means for a celebration. So tell us about your decision that you just made by going to cresthill.org/connect. Don't wait. Go to cresthill.org/connect. There you'll be directed to our church's website, and then you can just click the blue button that says connect. Fill out some information about yourself so that we can celebrate with you today about what you just did. Don't wait. Hit the blue button that says connect today. Also, if you say, hey, I know about Jesus, but I want to find a church home, you can be a part of Cresthill's fellowship wherever you are across the globe. So go to cresthill.org/connect to be a part of our Cresthill family today. So lastly, did you like what you saw today? Have you thought, I would love to spread the message of Jesus across the globe? Then go to cresthill.org/give to do just that. Help us spread the message of Jesus across the globe. God bless you. I also want to invite you to come next week. Matter of fact, don't just come by yourself. Have a watch party with your friends so that all of you can praise God together. Come along with Cresthill next week. We know that your time is precious, so we want to thank you so much for joining us today. We don't take it for granted. You could be doing so many other things this Sunday, but you decided to spend it with Cresthill, so we thank you. So lastly, we love you. God loves you. Never give up, never give in. And as always, keep the faith.